This is one of the most unique things I've found at the thrift store. These used to be a common sight in construction zones along the side of the highway, but not so much anymore. I guess due to a combination of cars these days having better headlights and there being better reflective paints and materials that they can put on construction barriers, that they don't need lights to help identify construction zones and keep people from crashing into them. This is a Dietz Visi-Flash made by R.E. Dietz Company of Syracuse, New York. This is model 650. It has a stamp of whatever road department owned it. If somebody recognizes this acronym, please leave a comment. Of course, it has a big orange reflector, which also says Syracuse, New York, USA. And there's the Dietz logo. These are battery-powered flashing lights. And they do have a photocell in them to turn them on when it gets dark, but there's also a manual switch inside. According to the information I found online, these were first introduced in the 1950s, and Dietz was in business until 2001. The older ones have a metal case, while this one has a plastic case, so it's probably from the 70s or 80s, or maybe even 90s. It's hard to tell, since the basic design didn't change all that much over the years. The lamp does swivel and it has a security screw on it, but thankfully it was only hand tight, so it can easily remove that. Then with the help of a screwdriver I can pry it open. Just slowly pry open each side. There we go, that's one side, and there's the other side. The bottom comes off, and there you can see the internals. There's that manual switch, and there's a little pinhole in the case. I guess it was designed to stick a tool through to turn it on or off. And then you can see the two bus bars where the batteries would connect to. And the circuitry is potted with wax to help keep moisture out of it. Now this internal piece is just press fit, so it just pulls out easily. There it is, all taken apart. I did have to replace the bulb. It uses an 1850 bulb. It's rated for 5 volts, even though the circuit runs on 6 volts. There you can see the photocell, which detects when it's dark and turns it on. It's circuit number 4507 PW1, also has a serial number and a patent number, which I'll look up, see when it's dated. There you can see those bus bars. The middle one is the negative and the outer one is the positive. And there's that switch to turn it on or off. I turned on the switch and I have my finger covering the photocell, so now if I hold it above the battery contacts, there it goes. Can run on just one battery, but it's designed to hold two for extra capacity. So now let's get it installed and see how it looks. I have one 6-volt lantern battery that I just bought at Harbor Freight, and one that is from 1999, but it still is good. Even though it's just heavy duty, it's not alkaline. This one even says zinc carbon on it. So these may leak, but this one hasn't leaked in over 16 years, 17 years. So these have a pretty good life, although this one you can hear it, something rattling inside it. And it was made in China, but it still works. So it looks like these batteries just slide into place here. Oh, it's already flashing, although you can't really see it from the camera angle. So now I'm going to put the cover in place. There we go. Just put that security screw into place. So there it is, fully installed. It's not flashing now because I have my lights on. Well, you can see it flashed once in a while, depending on how the light hits the photocell. But as I gradually turn off my lights, it should start flashing. There we go. And there it is, flashing away. It's not super bright, but definitely bright enough that somebody driving along the road at night could see it from some distance away. And here's that switch to turn it off. You just stick a little screwdriver in it. And there we go, it's off. And to turn it back on, you just stick the screwdriver in again. And of course, due to the reflector, it's the brightest when you view it head on. So that is the Dietz Visi-Flash Model 650 flashing away, as it was designed to do all night long to warn motorists of a construction zone. It's probably at least 25 or 30 years old, and all it needed was a new light bulb and some new batteries, and it works fine.